that you can't explain it. What can I say? It's complicated.
Hey. Nothing's that bad if it feels good. So you come back like I knew you would. And we're both wild and the night's young. Enjoy my drug, breathe you into my face, numb. Drop it down to that bass drum. I got what you dream about. Nails scratching my back, tat. Eyes closed when you scream out. And you keep me in with those hips. While my teeth sinking those lips. While your body's giving me life. And you suffocating my kiss. Then you said
I want you forever. Hey. Even when we're not together. Scars on my body so I can take you wherever. Like I want you forever. Even when we're not together. Scars on my body I can look at you and never get.
Fresh cut from my boy Nick the Barber. So I just got off the phone, got confirmation that I will be at the LA Fit Expo with Ghost at the Ghost booth both Saturday and Sunday. I'm pretty sure pretty much all day. So if you guys are in the area in LA or you guys are going to the Fit Expo, I will be there. I hope that I get to meet a lot of you guys. I look forward to it. We got all our Christmas shopping done, which is a ton. We got it all done in one night. Yeah, which is pretty damn good because it's for about four families, four or five. So I got a ton of my family here. All Sonia's family is here. It's we got a big family in Temecula. Just slipped one of Sonia's presents in her stocking. She has no idea. I'm so excited. So Christmas is pretty stressful. You know, the holidays, Christmas shopping is the most stressful. But once you get it done, it feels so much better. It feels so much better. Once everything is wrapped and it's under the tree, you can actually enjoy, like, waiting until Christmas morning, right? And it is crappy here in Southern California. It's been raining the past 2 days. It's supposed to rain till through tomorrow. Got a couple errands done while I was out getting my hair cut. Headed to campus now. Got a couple things to take care of on the computer. A couple new programs, new clients, gotta take care of, and then got a pull day today. Lately, I have been very, very motivated to train back because I know in my head that back is my lagging muscle group that I've been working on bringing up the past like 10 years. Genetically, I have very high lat inserts. I have a long torso, so my lats insert a lot higher, which makes my back look less wide. The way that I counter that is just I bring more attention to my back. I just really, really focus on killing it on pull days. That's one thing that I wanted to talk to you guys about is just kind of battling your genetics, right? So you can't change muscle insertions, how your muscle bellies look like. That's all genetically predisposed. If you have a very high bicep insert, it attaches very high. Your bicep is, you know, longer or shorter. You can't change that. The only thing that you can change is the size of your muscle. For example, my high lat inserts. I can put more mass on my lats and kind of hide the fact that my lats insert way up here versus down here, but you know, nothing's gonna change that. I can't stretch my lat and bring it down more, right? So all you can do is grow your muscle. And I've talked about that so many times, talked about that subject of progressive overload, focusing on progression while being in a surplus to actually make improvements. So that being said, my weakness, my lagging muscle group is my back. And a lot of the years I was not motivated to do it. I just hated pulling, but now I've slowly began to enjoy it. And in my head, I kind of turned it around saying that, like, come on, dude, this is your lagging muscle group. You have to focus on it more. You have to kill it. you have to do it. But lately, there's been a fire lit under, beneath me, and I've been looking forward to pull this. Whatever I did, it's working. But it's probably because, you know, I'm deep in my bulk and I know that I've been in a caloric surplus, that now is the time to turn it up and make sure I'm using these calories to benefit my gains.
This party, make sure you're safe even though you're going to want to drive.
So I'm gonna help Sony and Mail set up the bands. They couldn't figure it out. Did you move it?
Well, I had it right here.
It's supposed to be back there.
Oh yeah, right here, right?
No, the.
Oh, way back there. Oh.
Lock out a little more. There you go. Wind up. About 60, 61 each side at lockout. It's like 71. So that luggage scale is very useful. I just measured Sonia's and Male's height, where their lockout, where the bar is at, and they vary for just based on an inch. And then Dewan just pulled a conventional and we measured it, and I think it was about 70 pounds each side, one band for a lockout for his conventional setup. And we are kind of just going off of 100 pounds each, you know, hoping for the best, but they were not at, not even close to 100 pounds each. I think it's Foy, F-O-Y, sent me this water. It's this alkaline water that, what I've read on the bottle, it just has electrolytes and some minerals added to it. Some special water. You know, when it comes to water, you can definitely taste the difference between, like, the brand waters. You know, Aquafina, Fiji, Arrowhead. Arrowhead, I can definitely taste the difference. There's something in the water that just gives that like, sticky feeling. This is really smooth. And it's room temp. You know that feeling when you, like, gargle water, hits your teeth, and it feels like it kind of sticks to it? This feels really light. I don't know how to explain it. I can only imagine if I had it in the fridge and it was cold. Alright, so big thanks to Foy. Alright, lunchtime. I was going to eat there, but it was just packed. Panda Express. Every time I go in there, the line is just crazy. It's like a line of freaking Disneyland. Alright. I want fried rice today. Orange chicken. And then mushroom chicken. And then I got a Sierra Mist. This will be pre-workout. Oh, Santa's here. That's the sweetest. Is that a onesie?
Yeah.
It's the sweetest onesie I've ever seen. Can you put the hood on? Too cute. Starting off with pull-ups as usual. We got Toong hitting in with us. I'm gonna stick with the 45 pound dumbbell this week again. I really, really wanna get comfortable with it. Get good at that weight before I increase to the 50s.
Whole egg?
thrown in some seal rows, higher reps. It's a little bit lighter weight. Feels kind of good. Changing it up with my grip. A little wider than usual. Focusing on a nice contraction. Squeeze it, south top. Squeeze. Yeah, we decided to do seal rows because Roger was just doing them. So it was all set up. Teamwork. Whenever I train these days, with a hoodie on, I think I lose about 5 pounds of water. I can see it on my face, it totally changes. Is about 2 miles long, but it's well worth it. They got a radio station that is synced to the lights, Christmas lights on the houses. Getting tired? We're almost there.
Hold their lives for soldiers.
I think we got here at the right time. It's like, you can see that. That line is backed up about a mile.
Grown-ups would celebrate a bright Christmas day. But they all enjoy it.
We're almost there, Riley. What's tonight?
Pizza and eggs.
Are you happy now? We did Hawaiian today and the usual plain wings. Gatorade. And hot Cheetos is my go-to combo. I don't eat spicy foods. I can't handle spicy foods, but lately I've been on the hot Cheeto fix, and the way that I counter me not being able to handle hot food, spicy food, is Gatorade. I don't know.
It works for me.
The Gatorade that we use is, Sonya does this, the powder version for the girls. But we like this because you can kind of control, you know, how much sugar is in it. Water it down a little bit. And it's a lot cheaper. Thanks for watching today's vlog. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace.